This summer, El Nino conditions have become more prominent in the Pacific. NOAA declared that an El Nino pattern had begun back in June, and last month, ocean temperatures in this part of the Pacific were running several degrees higher than average. Water temperatures also increased compared to July. Another El Nino signal that forecasters look for is a change in the winds, and right now, surface winds over the Pacific are unusually westerly, while winds higher up in the atmosphere are unusually easterly. Given that, forecasters are now saying there is a 95% chance that El Nino conditions will last through this winter. There is also now a 71% chance for a strong El Nino to develop. But NOAA emphasized in today's forecast that a high probability for El Nino does not also equal a high probability for the specific impacts that this kind of pattern can bring. As an example, a strong El Nino has historically been linked to quiet Atlantic hurricane seasons, but so far this season has been relatively active with more named storms than average and more hurricanes than average. That's a reminder that there are always many different patterns at play when making a forecast for an entire season. Back to you.